Major announcements are expected to be made during Prime Minister Modi's third visit to Nepal this Friday. There is going to be a major thrust in the revival of the Ramayan circuit during Modi's trip, among other infrastructure and development projects. WION that symbol spoke to the Indian envoy to Nepal, Manjeev Singh Puri, on what to expect here.
The Indian Prime Minister is all set to visit Nepal. This will be his third visit to Nepal. With me is India's ambassador to Nepal. So welcome to WION. My first question is, what to expect from this visit?
Siddhant, thank you, and thank you to WION for coming to Kathmandu. Look, this is the second bilateral summit between Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and Prime Minister Shri KP Sharma Oli in a span of 1 month. Do you see the significance of this? Do you see the significance of our relationship? Prime Minister Modi made Nepal one of his first foreign tours after he assumed office in 2014. You know, Nepal and India are linked in so many ways. History, geography, nature are gods. And so, politically, being together and fostering politics, coming together and development has to be the top agenda item of all our governments. Mm-hmm. What do I expect from the visit? I expect that we take forward what we started when Prime Minister Oli went, which is to take forward the relationship in the direction of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, mm-hmm. and what the Nepalese say, Samrid Nepal, Khushi Nepali. Mm-hmm. We have identified three major areas: railways in connectivity, along with inland water transport, something which is absolutely new, and something which flows from our own decision to develop inland waterways in India, and agriculture. In railways, Raxaul Kathmandu is the shortest link to Kathmandu, less than 100 kilometers, but never attempted before because of the terrain, etc. We've decided to join hands with Nepal and see whether we can bridge this gap, and I'm sure we will be able to do it, for which we will move forward the railway connectivity. Inland water transport. As you know, this is a very big thing which our government has done over the past few years, and we are developing inland waterways in India. We're now connecting them to Nepal so that Nepal can, in that sense, have a link to the sea, and as they themselves like to see, that they are not landlocked, but they are locked in, but they're no longer locked in, and now they have a connectivity to the sea. The third big area that we've identified is an area of great importance to the economies and the people of both India and Nepal, which is agriculture. We are looking at developing a large new partnership in agriculture.
So India has provided a lot of development assistance to Nepal. India was the first country to send rescue missions when Nepal was struck by this massive earthquake. So clearly India has been helping Nepal in every way possible.
Well, partnership and development partnership is something which has always been there with us in India. And Nepal has been a country in which we've been in partnership for a very long time. You mentioned the earthquake. We were the first responders here, and we had to be the first responders. We also announced the largest amount of contribution to reconstruction here, $1 billion, of which $250 million is grant in aid. And I'm happy to tell you that that has also moved forward.
So Prime Minister Narendra Modi will be visiting three cities, Janakpur, Muktinath, and Kathmandu. The significance of visiting three cities, sir?
The Prime Minister lands at Janakpur. Janakpur, as you know, has an abiding link with India, the Ramayana. At Janakpur, he visits the Janaki Dham temple, and then he has a very large civic reception. At Janaki temple, he will be received by Prime Minister Oli. They will also announce a Ramayana circuit linking India and Nepal, and flag off a bus to Ayodhya. And we hope to, you know, enhance this people-to-people connectivity and deepen our Ramayana connections and the Ramayana circuit. In Kathmandu, the program includes a ceremonial welcome, talks with the Prime Minister, the inauguration, as I mentioned to you, the laying of the foundation stone of the Arun 3 project, a call on the President and the Vice President of Nepal.
And WION's principal diplomatic correspondent, Siddhant Sibol, is in Kathmandu, Nepal, to bring you all the minute-by-minute update on Prime Minister Modi's visit to Nepal this Friday. He brings you this report analyzing how the media in Nepal is reading the visit. Take a look.
The Indian Prime Minister is all set to arrive in Nepal tomorrow. His two-day visit to Nepal and also the third visit to this country. And newspapers are abuzz with the stories
on his visit to the country. Let's take a look at Kathmandu Post, a leading newspaper here in the country, and it has a graphic description of the three cities the Indian Prime Minister will be going: Janakpur, Kathmandu and Muktinath. And it has a plan also being chalked out, which has been put out here graphically on day one and day two. But a big focus is on inking railway and waterways pact. An agreement on waterways navigation on Kosi River will be announced during the visit. And of course, a team of India's Inland Water Navigation Authority will conduct a feasibility study, and both the countries will amend the Treaty of Transit also. Inside of Kathmandu Post also, there is a description on what to expect. The big focus, of course, on Janakpur. Janakpur all set to welcome Prime Minister Modi. Let's take a look at Republica. It, of course, focuses on the budget priorities of the Nepali finance minister, which he says is to mobilize foreign assistance to areas of national priority. India provides a lot of foreign assistance to Nepal, but inside of it, it has pictures, and pictures do tell a thousand stories, and it has pictures of a man putting Indian flag along with Nepal's flag in the city. But editorial have the big focus, the opinion of the people here in the country. It has the editorial page has two editorials. First, here, time to deliver. Indian Prime Minister's visit to religious sites could prove another milestone in promoting religious tourism in Nepal. Remember, Nepal heavily backs its on tourism to getting a lot of money from the incoming visitors, and a lot of people come from India. But also lately, China has cashed up, and a lot of Chinese tourists come to Nepal. And this finally has this editorial: letter to Modi. Nepalis love India. That is why India should not hurt their feelings of Nepalis, and that fuels the anti-India feeling.